and authority vested in me. Jehovah, I release the anointing right now. The anointing that shall break every yoke. Oh, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We give you all the glory. It's time to immerse yourself into the presence of God. If you are not in God, you are with the devil. There are two masters. It's either you are on the left, it's either you are a goat or a sheep. The Bible says, in the last days, he shall separate the goat from the sheep, and the sheep shall be in the right side. I want you to take this moment, child of God, to move on the right side. The Bible says the right side of the right hand of God is the right hand of power.
So Paul is using this illustration that you are brand new creation. You've come into a whole new world. You are not the same person that you used to be. You are linked up to the very DNA of Jesus.
Revelation TV, the channel that is all about delivering God's people, that is all about setting God's people free. Indeed, this is a day that the Lord has made, and in it we rejoice and be glad in it. I'm a presenter, Senior Puri, and with me in the studios, I'm being joined by my co-presenter, who is also just going to introduce himself as we proceed through this moment of devotion. Good morning, Mr. Lam.
Good morning, Senior.
Fine, thank you.
You look nice in that black t-shirt.
Oh, thanks.
Yes. Good morning, viewers. My name is Lavu Gambo. I'm also going to anchor this program this morning as we discuss certain issues pertaining to soul winning, as well as partnering with Liberation TV. So just joining us, this is a moment of devotion. It comes to you every from Monday to Friday from 7:30 hours to 9:30 hours. So you can, the number is on the screen. You can call that number if you want to partner with us, or if you want to just get any information regarding how you can become a partner of Liberation TV. Remember, partnering in God's work, you're not doing God a favor, but you're doing yourself a favor. Because God gives us blessings so that you can spend more towards His work. So when you give towards God's work, you're not doing God a favor, because God has abundance of wealth which He uses to bless us. And when He does that, He wants us to spend even more towards His work. So once you give to God's work, you are doing up, you are storing, it's like an insurance cover that you have. Because we insure our vehicles, we insure our houses, we insure everything. So for unforeseen circumstances, in case of fire, we're able to get that place. Now, what happens when we die? Okay, because like the Bible says that, you know, in heaven you store up, okay, because no thief can break in and steal a blessing which you store up there in heaven. So even as we go on with the program, be put in mind that you need to invest in the things of God, because you are investing for the future. Okay, it's like you are, it's your cover, and insurance cover to say, when I go to meet my maker, you have somewhere to start from, and you find all that investment that you make into God's work. Send you.
Yes, indeed. It's very important for us to invest in the things of God, because unlike the things of the world, don't even last just for a short while. Before we realize it, they just vanish. But when we invest in the things of God, when we make the decision to support the work of God, God comes through for us. So even as we're talking about partnership this morning, we're encouraging you, obvious out there, to make that state by partnering with Revelation TV. And I know as you do that, as you remember to partner with us, God is also going to remember you. Moreover, the word of God tells us to say that blessed is the hand that giveth more than that which receiveth. So you that will be giving, you that will be investing into Revelation TV are the ones that will be even getting more blessed, more than us that will be receiving. Like Mr. Lovely Kayombo said here to say, you know, when you're giving, it's not for God's benefit, but it's for your own benefit. Because as a result of you giving into the kingdom of God, you're the one who is going to sow that which you reap into the kingdom of God. So we are encouraging you to partner with us. Remember that you can always partner with us through Zapit, and the number usually runs on your screen. That's how you can partner with Revelation TV and just get it to be a blessing to the work of God. You know, in life we have to learn to sacrifice, you know, that which we have. And if we give from the bottom of our hearts, if we give out of love, God is just going to come through for us. Even the word of God does tell us to say that God loves a cheerful giver. So if you want to be loved by God, be a cheerful giver. Not giving because you've got nowhere else to take those stuff. Not giving because you want everybody to see, say you're the one who always gives, but giving because you want to see through to say, you know, something and someone benefits out of what you are giving. And giving to God just to see through to say, you know, we expand the kingdom of God, to see through to say people out there get blessed, people get touched, and together we shall glorify the name of the Most High God.
Yeah, and I think before we go on with the program, it is important that every morning we wake up, we just take a bit of water, because water has a lot of benefits. And I think before we go on with our topic, which is winning souls today, I want us to run through the six benefits of us drinking maybe about 4 or 5 glasses every morning we wake up. Because you know, water makes up almost 55 to 75% of water in our bodies, depending on the body size. And the benefits of water, the first one that I got from the search, okay, is that the amount of water you consume every day plays an important role in maintaining a healthy body. Experts recommend that we drink 8 to 10 glasses of water each day to maintain a good health. And the first benefit of drinking water is one, if it relieves fatigue. Okay, if you often feel tired, then there's a high chance that you are dehydrated. So drinking a lot of water will help to ease to relieve that fatigue that you have. Because sometimes people wake up in the morning feeling tired, okay, as if they've been, you know, cultivating throughout the night, and yet maybe the answer lies in the amount of water that they took before going to sleep. So scientists recommend that we drink 8 to 10 glasses every morning to relieve that fatigue. Because sometimes I also, you know, experience such where you wake up every in the morning feeling, you know, tired.
But
the moment you drink, you know, maybe 2 or 3 cups of water, you start feeling, you know, energized. Then number two, it helps to improve the mood. Okay, research indicates that mouth dehydration, okay, negatively affects our mood and our line of thinking. Because if you are dehydrated, okay, because the brain also is made up of a large amount of water. So if we don't take enough water, you know, it, you know, disturbs our mood. Maybe you wake up at now kilako left. Okay, you wake up and at now kilako left there. And then maybe it's just the dehydration that you have. So lack of water, okay, also you know, determines your mood and also your overthinking that morning. Sometimes people, you know, have problems to, you know, to, you know, think when they're at work. People are asked to chase in the emotion. So maybe it could be that you have a less amount of water in your body. Then number three, it helps to treat headaches, because headaches also are often caused by dehydration. So if you're having a headache early in the morning or even in the afternoon, it's maybe lack of enough water in your body. So you need to drink, you know, as much water as possible when you wake up in the morning. Then it also helps in digestion and constipation. So water improves function of the gastrointestinal tract where the food passes, and this helps to improve digestion and prevents constipation. Because at times people, you know, they will eat, then the food does not digest. Some of them are, you know, like running gases in your stomach. So you need to drink a lot of water to avoid, you know, just improve your digestion system, so that, you know, the food in your system is able to, you know, be digest and prevent constipation. And then it also helps with weight loss. I'm told you want to lose weight. Since. So what you do is, before you eat, you drink 2 cups of water. These are the scientists who are recommending this. I'm not a doctor. So I'm told you want to reduce your weight. So what you do is, before you eat a gym or any meal, drink 2 cups of water. That helps to, you know, your appetite, okay? It will, your appetite will be little. And as a result, you're not going to eat enough food. So by doing that, you're preventing Martin to lose weight. Okay. Then the last one, it helps to flush out toxins in the body. So the more water you drink, you know, toxins come in different forms, through urine, also, you know, sweat. So let's keep on drinking enough water every morning. Because as Christians, we also need to be healthy. Okay. Because we can't be Christians who are always sickly every morning, not to be seen with emotion. So remember that scientists recommend us to drink 8 to 10 glasses of water per day if you are able to manage. You drink maybe 3 in the morning, mid-afternoon, evening. So that you will prevent headaches, constipation, and also fatigue. So I recommend, I'm a doctor recommending to you, to drink 8 to 10 glasses every day so that you have a healthy body.
Sure, yes, I know that water is very vital to our bodies, and that's very important for us to, you know, in a day, at least 2 liters of water into our bodies, because scientifically 70% of the human body is water. So if you want to, you know, live a healthy life, you want to all the body functions that are taking place in the inside of our bodies to operate very well, we need to take a lot of water. I do agree with you, Mr. Kayombo, concerning water this morning.
Okay. And so, like we are, I discussed earlier on that this morning, want to look at soul winning, okay? Soul winning, in relation to what we are doing at the Revelation TV, encouraging you to partner with us so that we continue to spread the gospel. And by doing that, we are winning souls to the kingdom of God. And so winning, I'll just read here, is that we must be soul winners, okay? Because that is the great commission, the great command, the great mandate, the great instruction, the great order given to us by our Lord Jesus and Savior. Okay, and I'll read from the book of Matthew 28, verse 18 to 20. Mm. Okay, the Bible says, "Then Jesus came to them and said, 'All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations.'" Okay, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. So Jesus Christ tells us that, you know, we are commissioned to winning souls, okay? Baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mm. So Christians, they are watching, okay? The Revelation TV, what we are doing is what? Is to reach out to millions of people through the TV ministry, so that we can have people repenting and getting to know Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. And so we encourage you, our viewers, to partner with us so that you can continue to carry on this work. Because even senior, you and I, we are all commissioned to win souls. Mm. Okay, that could be mentioned is that there's more joy in heaven when one person repents.
Mm.
Okay, so we are all commissioned to become soul winners, okay? Because in the Bible here is saying that go and make disciples of all nations.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we are sitting in the studio, people are watching us, and not just here within Zambia, but those across borders. So we are going in all nations,
mm-hmm.
okay,
mm-hmm.
preaching what? The gospel. And through the TV ministry, people are watching us maybe outside Zambia, through their local church. Okay, they will know the Jesus Christ through Revelation TV, and they want to know more and get baptized. And they'll find a local church nearby,
mm.
where they're watching us from, and they get baptized and they get saved.
Mm.
So by doing that, you're partnering with us, would have saved the purpose of us, what? Going out to the nations, preaching the gospel and baptizing what? The saved people in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So a partnership will really help us to go out, okay? Because we're already going out, and not just here in Zambia, but people in the gospel are able to catch a Revelation TV. So the partnership that the people make towards Revelation TV, it's to help us reach out to all nations.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said in the opening, that when you give towards the work of God,
mm-hmm.
you're not doing God a favor, but you're doing yourself what? A favor.
Yes.
It's like we have bank accounts, isn't it? We have insurance cover. So every month we go and deposit something in our bank accounts or insurance, because we don't know what is what, unforeseen circumstances. So the same thing applies when you give towards the work of God, you are insuring yourself, it's a cover, okay? Because when you die, you find it's stored up, because no one will steal that away from you. There's no interest or whatever. So whatever you give is what? Multiplied, it's kept for your very self. We are no rust, no cockroaches, no thief can break in and steal what you sell. So when you partner with us, you're not doing God a favor, no. It's your cover, okay? The way we do for insurance, for unforeseen circumstances, like in case my house catches fire, you have the insurance company to come and pay you money to build another one.
Mm.
Same thing applies, invest in God's work, and the benefits are eternal benefits that could be mentioned here.
Mm.
So don't think, I'm giving Revelation TV to make maybe our vision color process fit the rich. No, what you are giving the money is what you are giving God the money. I'm not giving apostles fit the money. No, the money we pledge and we partner with us helps us to what? To carry on with our broadcast and reaching out to millions of people who are watching us throughout Zambia and those across borders. Like we mentioned, that running a TV station is not an easy venture to go into, because of the running cost which comes with the running a TV station. Because as we run 24 hours, okay, so we have bills, the fixed bills, okay,
mm.
we need to pay a soccer water and storage company,
mm.
we need to replace the microphones we're using here, the cameras we have, the lovely machines behind us there,
mm.
And even you know, the backdrops of these beautiful backdrops, they need to be you know, replaced time to time. So we keep on you know, going on with our broadcast. And I've got t-shirts, the one that Senior is putting on. If you become a partner, I think you can have a shirt, a t-shirt like that one. And we have this, okay? They're called My Story Must Change with Apostle Stanford Fitter. So if you become a partner with us, you get yourself a free t-shirt. We have in suited colors, we've got black, we also have red and other colors are available for your partner. So when you make your pledges and your partner with us, we simply give you a free t-shirt. We also have t-shirts for children. So if you're a parent, you partner with us, you can also have t-shirts for children, okay? So I think that as you are moving as a family, you are moving not in uniformity, okay? We have a red one, this one can be for the father, okay? For your child, this one, we have for children. And also, so we are catering across, you know, all the family members that you have. So if you partner with us, you get yourself this t-shirt in black, this one for your child. Also have different colors available, depending on how you want it. Also have this one in red, okay? It's written, my father behind, okay? Here it's written, my story must change. So if you partner with us, your story will surely change and you will be a testimony and be a blessing to other people. So when you give, you also open doors for more to come and people will give you.
Yes, indeed. These are lovely t-shirts that we're giving out to our partners. As long as you partner with Revelation TV, you are guaranteed for these beautiful t-shirts like Mr. Kayombo there is saying, parents, mothers, and children, they should be in uniformity.
Yes.
The father should be in the black.
People
the mother
should be proud
in
to say, no, I'm a partner of Revelation TV. You know,
yes.
This beautiful t-shirt.
Yes.
So even as you are moving, you're moving with your head high to say, no, I'll help to reach out to those and reach people through my partnership.
Yes, indeed. So partner with us, make that decision now. This is your opportunity just to tap into this grace, just to tap into this anointing. And I know that as you do that, God is just going to come through for you and meet you at your very point of need. Bro, if you want to get one like this one, you'll also find it right here at Tabernacle Mission Revival Center and at Revelation TV. So partner with us. These t-shirts are a guarantee. It's not like we are trying to lie or anything just to earn self-benefit, but this is very much true. When you partner with us, we are guaranteeing you for these lovely t-shirts of My Story Must Change. These are the ones written, my father, My Story Must Change with Apostle Stanford Chipita, just like the one I'm putting on in black. So we have them in three colors, like Mr. Kayombo was saying, we have them in black, we have them in red as well as blue. And for the kids as well, we do have them in red and black. So just in case you're a partner there as a mom, you're a partner there as a dad, you can also get your child a t-shirt of My Story Must Change. Just, you know, trying to, you know, promote your child to say, even as you grow up, learn to be a partner in God's work, and together we shall glorify the name of the Most High God. Like Mr. Kayombo was saying, to say, you know, when you're giving into Revelation TV, you're not giving to, you know, to make the vision carrier big, you're giving to the work of God, because by the end of the day, Revelation TV has to go beyond this. We have to reach nations out there, we have to reach the world out there. How do you reach the world out there if you have no, you know, finances? So we need you to help us and to partner with us through Zapit. And I know as you deposit those amounts of money into the bank account, Revelation TV's bank account, I know that God is going to come before you and meet you at your very point of need. Revelation TV is a big church that is reaching out there to, you know, different churches under different denominations. And if you just get to, you know, to analyze that situation, to say, okay, how are we managing here? How are we able to buy these facilities that we have right here in our studios? Well, we can only buy these facilities right here in our studios as a result of you, our viewers out there, partnering with us and supporting Revelation TV. Because by the end of the day, Revelation TV is all about delivering God's people. It's all about setting God's people free. So tap into this grace, tap into this anointing. You can never know what God can do for you as a result of being concerned of others. on Saturday during the light morning, like we're talking about, selfishness, and we say, you know, selfishness is just being an attitude of being, having your interest above the interest of others. So if you want to be concerned about your neighbors out there, it's all as a result of love. We need to have love in the inside of us and live a selfless life. But just once, you know, consider the needs of somebody. Just once, consider, someone's, you know, or where someone is having a gap and they're in need of that thing, they need of that spiritual benefit. That's why we do encourage you, our viewers out there, to make that decision to partner with us. As a result, you know, of you partner with us, we have, you know, plenty of stuff. We have, you know, every facility that we need to have right here on Revelation TV, just to keep the TV station running day in and day out. We need those facilities, and those facilities will come as a result of you partnering with us. So these t-shirts are a guarantee to every partner of My Story Must Change. We are delegating for free of charge at no cost at all, because you've made that decision to partner with us and just support the work of God, and just, you know, making that decision to move with the man of God's vision, and that is delivering God's people. And as you do that, I believe that, you know, God is going to see you through and meet you at your very point of need. You can partner with us with a 200 scratcher, a 300, 400, 500, even as far as a 1,000, as far as God can bless. You can even go beyond the 1,000, just being a blessing to the work of God. And I know that God is going to see you through. You know, like we were saying the previous days, we're talking about, you know, keeping your hands folded like this when you have something in your hand and just keeping it tight like this, and like you don't release that thing, you're not going to receive, because you have that thing tied to your hand. But when you lose that thing off your hand, definitely you are going to receive even more than that which you have released out of your hand. So what are we saying here? Let us learn to be givers. Let us learn to support the work of God. And as we learn to give into the kingdom of God, not everything requires us to pray, not everything requires us to fast, but there are certain things that do require us to be givers in the house of the Lord, to be givers the thing that concerns the work of God. And I believe that together we shall uplift the name of the Lord God Almighty.
Thank you. In case you are just joining us, this is a moment of devotion. It comes to you from Monday to Friday, from 7:30 hours to 9:30 hours. And I'd like to thank Elder Ngurube for those words of encouragement that you are giving us here at Revelation TV. And we appreciate such words of encouragement, you know, as it helps us also to do even more in reaching out to people who are watching. So once again, thank you very much, Elder Ngurube, for that word of encouragement that you just sent to us at Revelation TV. We are really humbled, and may God richly and bless you. And reading from the book of Matthew 22, verse 14, the title here, what I want to mention is that we must be soul winners, because we are all called to this great work of what? Soul winning. And so we need to just read, this is Matthew 22, I think I just read that one. So we must be soul winners, because we are all called to this great work of soul winning. Okay, so it's our duty as Christians to reach out to a lot of people. Because you know that sometimes we don't realize the purpose why we are saved as Christians. The moment we are baptized, we do not understand what it means for us to become baptized members of the church. But what the Bible is telling us is that, you know, we are saved to reach out to many people, to evangelize and win souls. Because it's our duty, to bring millions of people to know Jesus Christ. Because once you are saved, and then you just become an idle member of the church. At the end of the day, people, they backslide, they stop going to church because they find no meaning of going to church every Sunday. Because all they do is they go in church, they sit, the preaching finishes, they go home, But once you engage yourself in a church activities, like reaching out to people, evangelizing, you become part of the church and you feel to do even more. So the issue of you wanting to stay at home every Sunday, you are moved. To say, no, I've got that duty to reach out to people. So let me go to church. After church, you go out in the field, get one or two people to know Jesus. And by that, you also become, you feel that you have a purpose, as a Christian. Because if you, just, sit, after church service, off you go home. And even when the sermon which was given at church, you even forget. The moment you leave church, you will forget the sermon that was preached at church, because your mind is preoccupied with what? something else.
Mm.
But once we know the purpose why we are saved as Christians,
mm.
we also learn to know, okay, to be meditate over the sermons that are preached in the church. I remember I met one man of God who was telling me that people who always forget what they dream at night, they have a problem,
mm.
okay? Because God communicates to us through what?
Dreams.
Mm. Okay? He communicates to us through dreams. So what? You know, God tells us things through dreams. And if you're in the habit of forgetting what you dream of at night, then you have a problem. Because you do not know what God is trying to tell you. Okay? Because God will tell you, no, through your dream, okay, maybe what not to do tomorrow.
Mm.
But if you wake up at what a child in at Kanaiva, then you have a problem. Because God communicates us through what? Dreams. The same thing applies to when we get baptized.
Mm.
God, when we are baptized, then we have a great commission also to win other people to Jesus. And the book of Matthew 22, verse 14, verse 16, okay? No, not this one. Matthew 20, verse 16. Psalm number 24. 20, verse 16. Okay. Yes, but so when you say the last shall be the first, and the first will be last, said to them, they are all going up to Jerusalem. The Son of Man will be betrayed to the chief priests and the teachers of the law. They will condemn him to death and will turn over to the Gentiles to be mocked, flogged, and crucified on the third day of the death. Come back to this scripture later on. It is Matthew 20, verse 16. There's a point I wanted to elaborate based on this scripture.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but before I come to this, I want to quote what William Booth said. He's the founder of Salvation Army. Okay, so he says, open quote, I believe that in each generation, God has got enough men and women to evangelize all the yet unreached tribes. Okay, so you and I, the people are watching us, we are all called, okay, to evangelize all the yet unreached what? Tribes of the earth. It is not God who does not call, okay, it is man who will not respond, end of quote.
Mm.
So God always knocks on our doors, okay, like I said, he comes through dreams to communicate certain messages to us. Okay, and if we forget what God is trying to tell us, then we're not able to achieve this. So William Booth, the founder of Salvation Army, said, I believe that in each generation, God has got enough men and women to evangelize all the yet unreached tribes of the earth. It is not God who does not call, it is man who will not respond.
Yes.
So God calls us. Okay, so maybe you can also share more on this one, what you think yourself as a Christian, okay? That God always calls us, okay, but we do not respond.
Mm-hmm. That's very true indeed. God does call us, but you know, the problem we do have as human beings is that we fail to respond. When God is calling us into, you know, the field, like as a Christian, many of the times, you know, when we get born again, when we get saved, we just sit for the sake of, yeah, I'm saved. So by the end of the day, I have accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior, and I know that I'm guaranteed for heaven. But not realizing to say there is more to being saved, not just being saved and, you know, sitting and folding our arms, there is much more to being saved. And, you know, Christianity has a lot of responsibilities. We have to, you know, have that ability to respond towards the things of God. You know, we should be people who are always concerned about others. When you yourself, the fact that you have accepted Jesus Christ as a Lord and personal Savior, you are saved quite right. But what about your neighbor who has not even heard anything about the gospel, has not heard, you know, the gospel preached to them, telling them to say, you know, Jesus loves you, give your life to Christ and confess your sins? What about them? That's what we should really, you know, when we sit down, we should analyze in such situations and begin to say, in as much as I'm saved, I also have to help out my, you know, my neighbors out there. I also have to help out my relatives out there, also to, you know, receive this gift of salvation. You know, salvation could be, you know, something that has been delegated to us freely, but it is not cheap. It is very expensive. It costed God a son, and that is Jesus. So we have to treasure this gift. In as much as yes, we have accepted Jesus Christ, we don't have to sit down and fold our arms and, you know, just say, okay, fine, I've accepted him and I know that I'm guaranteed for eternal life. By the end of the day, I'll enter heaven. That's not how Christianity should be. We should stand our grounds when we get saved and tell ourselves, what next after I'm saved? I must save my God in the house. What next after I'm saved? I must preach to somebody also to receive Jesus Christ as a Lord and personal Savior. So I think, you know, sitting down when we get saved is just being selfish. And like, if you're concerned about others, you go out there, we'll go into, you know, into the streets out there, into communities, into societies, to preach the word of God and telling the whole world just how good our God is and just how, you know, precious he is to us and how he loved us. Because moreover, God loved us before we loved him. The fact that, you know, he gave us Jesus Christ as our Savior today for us to enjoy this salvation, for us to enjoy this eternal life, it's as a result of the love of God. So even as we have to, you know, portray the love of God, show our neighbors out there, show our friends out there the love that God has shown unto us by preaching to them, by winning souls out there. Like Mr. Kambi was saying, you know, winning souls is a commissioning, and not just a commissioning, it's a command as well. God does command us to go out there, you know, to preach to somebody. The word of God is saying, you know, all man, nothing man except God a soul. So if there is anything that we should, all God is a soul. We have to take after this responsibility as Christians to go out there in the field and preach the good news to everybody, so that we see to see that by the end of the day, everybody received Jesus Christ as a Lord and personal Savior. And, you know, they also preach to others as a result of us preaching to them. They also, you know, take after that responsibility to respond to others out there and telling them to say, oh, you know what, for me to be like this today, for me to be enjoying this, you know, this salvation, to be enjoying this gift of righteousness, is as a result of somebody preached to me. And I'm also here to preach to you so that you should also receive Jesus Christ as a Lord and personal Savior. So this is not time to sleep as Christians. It's time to rise up on our feet and, you know, enter communities, enter societies, preaching the good news, not just being self-centered, being selfish, and that's not right. Like we were speaking the previous Saturday, we have to rise up on our feet. And, you know, like you're saying, to say, you know, God does call us, but the problem with us is that we don't respond. Many are called, but few are chosen. So if you want to be chosen by God, you have to take after that responsibility, preaching the good news out there. That's just one way of responding to what, you know, God has called you for, responding to the power of God that God has invested in the inside of you, but releasing that power to others as well. You know, just to see to it, to say, by the end of the day, we don't condemn anybody, but preaching to them in love, telling them to say, you know, I was also in this predicament. I also experienced such a predicament. I also experienced such a shame. I was also a sinner at some point, but today I've made this decision to accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior. And I'm here to preach to you out of love, not out of condemnation, out of love, to say also, you know, abandon your old ways, abandon, you know, the sinful nature. Let the sinful nature die out of you. Let the spirit leave. God loves you so much. Accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. You know, others out there, they don't respond as a result of how we reach out to them. Just reach out, hey, you are a sinner. God will punish you. You know, you're going to burn in hell. That's not how we reach out to people. And that's not how we can win souls. We have to win souls out of love. Going there in a way, you know, not condemning them, but trying to win them to God, to push them, to draw them closer to God, telling them to say, God loves you. I think that's how we should live as Christians, and that's just how, you know, we should portray such behaviors when we go out there. Not behaviors that will destroy others, not behaviors that will, you know, discourage others, but that which will encourage somebody. Even say, but I think, okay, what my brother was preaching to me, what my sister has been preaching to me is very true. Person will sit down because you reached out to them. We reached out to them out of love, not out of condemnation, and telling them to say, I think I must really make that decision to accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior. Why? Because, you know, approach does matter at times. You can't just preach, hey, God will punish you, hey, yeah, sinner. No, we should not condemn, but we should preach to them out of love, and having that, you know, that thing in mind, to say, at the end of the day, we are one who draw them close to God. We have to decrease the kingdom of darkness and increase the kingdom of the light, I think.
Yeah, I think, like you've mentioned, sometimes when the approach it matters, so even us must be patient, even as we evangelize. Because we don't expect results there and then. You go to a person today and expect them to, you know, convert overnight. Mm-hmm. So we need to be patient also, even as we, you know, reach out to people, because there are those who are very flexible. Mm-hmm. Okay, you knock on their door, they will come in. Others knock on their door, they even pour you hot water. Okay, mm-hmm. But that's not stop you from going back there. Okay, because it's a process. Okay, because people cannot change overnight.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, because they have to deal with their issues. So we need to be patient also, as members always say, like I mentioned, that because if you're not patient, you expect someone not to convert overnight, then you know you lose the whole purpose of evangelizing. But you need to give people time, okay? Keep on knocking until they'll finally they'll open up their hearts to you, so they're able to evangelize and also, you know, to win their souls. Because let's say when you're doing mass communication, for you to convince someone, okay, you must keep on repeating the same message. It's like advertising, okay?
Yes.
You know what this pen is, but just by if you see it. So that reputation every day, I'm seeing the same advert, to stick to your mind. And even it's a point whereby, if it's on TV, you know each and every word in that advert. So the same thing applies to evangelizing, okay? Keep on knocking, okay? Preaching the gospel. Until that person now finally says, no, they'll start to even, you know, knowing word by word or verse by verse in the Bible, okay? Because if you expect results there, then the whole purpose of you going up there will be defeated, okay? So you need to be patient even as you evangelize, because people are different, okay?
Yes.
There are those same day you relate. Okay, because they say for someone to understand you, you must have the same what, at the same magical frame of reference. It must be your experiences. Okay, must somehow what be the same. If you don't know Jesus, okay, I know Jesus. If I come to you, it'll be that confusion to say, but what is the person trying to say? Those who are flexible, they might have heard about Jesus, okay, you might have read the Bible before. So if you go to them, they were able to relate with you, say, oh, what this person is saying is what is in the Bible, okay? So they sit down with you, and what you start adding on to what they know, and at the end of the day, they will, you know, convert and get to know Jesus. But those, if you're not at the same, you know, your experiences differ, then you have a problem.
Yes.
So you need to start now building to make them understand what you are trying to say. Because even in communication, okay, if I tell something you never heard of before, you will not understand.
No.
So for you to understand what I'm talking, you must have heard it somewhere. So you're able to relate with me as I am explaining to you. So if you and I are not on the same page, same frequency, okay, you and I cannot understand each other. So if you are going out to evangelize, you have to put in mind that communication is always, you know, a lapse. Okay, if someone has not experienced what you have experienced before, even as you explain to them, they're not able to relate with you. If someone has an idea about who Jesus Christ is, they'll be more flexible to you and you want to know more. But those who have not heard it before, they'll be, you know, more defensive. So you need to be patient with such people, okay? Give them time to learn bit by bit until they understand. Like I read in the book of Mark, chapter 16, verse 15, going down, okay, it's about the Great Commission, okay, what God has called us to do. And before Jesus left, he told his disciples to say, go into all the world and preach the good news to all creation. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved, but whoever does not believe will be condemned. And these signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out what? Demons. They will speak in new tongues. They will pick up snakes with their hands. And when they drink deadly poison, do not hurt them at all. They will place their hands on sick people and they what? They will get well. So, Jesus is telling us that we need to go out, okay, into the world and preach the good news to all creation. And whoever believes is baptized and will be saved. But whoever does not believe will be condemned. Okay. So now we have a big task here. Okay. Like Jesus said, it did not come for the righteous. He came to save those who are not righteous. So even us, he's saying that we preach to all creations, that they be baptized and what? Saved. So those who will not believe will be what? Condemned. So we have a duty now as Christians to get as many people as possible to be saved, okay? So that they also be able to drive out demons, they will speak in tongues, they will pick up snakes with their hands, they will drink poison but it will not help them, and they will heal the sick when they lay their hands on them. So our job now is to get these people who are not saved, not to get condemned but to be saved and also enter the kingdom of God. And the book of Ephesians, Ephesians 2, verse 10, okay? Because we are created for what? To do good works, okay? And the Bible is saying that, for we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. And here we are saying that it's not God who does not call, it's us who do not respond.
Yes.
Okay? So God calls us, but we do not respond. Okay? And you mentioned that more are invited, but a few are chosen. So we are all created to do what? To do good works. And in this case now, is to also, you know, to make people also experience the goodness of being a Christian. And we need to go out there and just bring them so they get what? They get saved and enter the kingdom of God. So if you are watching out there, you are all created to do good works. And so if you want to continue doing good works and reaching out to many people, please find it in your heart also to help this ministry to go forward. So as you continue to preach the gospel to all creations in this country and those across the borders to know Jesus Christ. And once we do that, then we achieve the purpose of what we are commissioned for. Okay? Because we are commissioned, we are commanded, we are mandated and instructed, okay, by Jesus himself to do what? To win souls so that people are saved. And in case you are a man of God, a woman of God, we're also inviting you to come through to Russian TV from Monday to Fridays to come and also minister to people right here in the studios at only 250 Kwacha for 25 minutes. And also by you coming here also, you're also helping move this TV ministry forward. And so if you're watching us, we're inviting you to come through to the Russian TV and just pay 250 Kwacha for 25 minutes and be able to preach and also reach to millions of people who are craving for the word of God. And if you're also a musician, an artist, you have music videos and want to, you know, promote them, we're also able to do that for you at only 200 Kwacha per month. So simply bring your videos here in MP4 format or any format that you have, but we'll still convert it for you at only 200 Kwacha for 1 month, which is 30 days in a month. Your video will be playing every day and people get to know you also. And you also get to minister to people through your music. And also those who play live music, you play keyboard and you're able to sing, can also call the number on the screen there and make an appointment with us so that we can also invite you to come in the studio and also play and minister to people through the music.
Yes, indeed, you're still watching the live morning live that comes to you every day from Mondays 7:30 hours to Fridays to 9:30 hours. And like Mr. Lemon says, this is where we do encourage men and women of God to come through to Revelation TV and just get to be a blessing to God's people out there at only a cost of 250 Kwacha. And I know as you make a decision as a woman of God out there just to minister to somebody out there, just to make sure to say, you know, our soul is one out there, just for you coming to Revelation TV and being a blessing on Moment of Devotion, I know that God is going to come through for you and meet you at your very point of need. Just 550 Kwachas ministering to somebody. Just wanted to see to you to say a soul is one out there and heaven will rejoice over one soul that is one in comparison to the 99 who already know Jesus Christ and who have already accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and personal Savior. As we're still talking about, you know, soul winning out there, we need to go into the field and preach the good news. And, you know, we have to see, we need to say everybody hears the good news. And at that day, when you do your part as a child of God, when you do your part as a Christian, preaching to somebody out there, on that day you won't be held accountable before God, because God will be asking, yeah, I gave you life. What did you do for me on that day? You're just moving up and down, you know, just doing all these sorts of bad things. But rather make that right decision to go up there to preach the good news to somebody. Even as the word of God is saying, you know, the harvest is plenty, but the workers are few. So if we want to till the land more, we need more workers in the kingdom of God. We need people to go out there to venture into, you know, the entire world out there to preach the good news, to preach the losses. We need to warn, we need to win souls out there for Jesus, not just us sitting and just wanting to see us benefit out of our own, you know, Christianity, but also being concerned about others. It's very important, as I love to say, that, you know, we cannot be saying, God, I love you, Jesus, I love you, I love you, I love you. In the actual sense, we hate our neighbors. That doesn't make sense. We should first start by loving our neighbors, wanting to see that what my friend is doing is very bad, and that will lead them to go to hell. I must preach them so that they may find their lives, you know, rejoicing in heaven. This is one way of being concerned. So what are we saying here? We're saying, you know, as Christians, let us pull up our stockings, let us rise up on our feet and preach the good news out there. Let us, you know, see to it to say the entire world gets served through this wonderful TV station, which is Revelation TV. It's all about delivering God's people. It's all about setting God's people free. Yes, the harvest is plenty, the workers are few. So we need to work into the kingdom of God in order for us to reduce the harvest, because the harvest is a lot. We're not working as Christians. We're just seated and we just have our hands folded and telling ourselves, convincing ourselves to say, no, everything is fine. As long as I'm saved, yes, I am on the safe side. And like those that are saved, it's their fault. They know what they're doing. No, we should be concerned, knowing to say, maybe those people are not changing as a result of us not going out there, you know, preaching to them. They are craving to see to it. So somebody comes and tells them to say, my brother, what you're doing is wrong. What you're doing is not right. By the end of the day, these things that you're doing, they're going to lead you astray. You find yourself, you know, in hell, or you find yourself dead. So we should, you know, go out there in as much as, yes, we want to be on the safe side, but we should also be concerned about others, the well-being of others. So say, in as much as I want to see myself, you know, go to heaven on that day, I must preach to somebody. So let us reduce, you know, let us make sure to say the harvest starts reducing now, not waiting, you know, for years to come saying, I think when I sit down first and analyze things, this is the time, because time wasted is never again. Tomorrow never comes. This is the right time for us to rise up on our feet and go out there, venture into the world, preaching the good news to people out there, going into bars. You know, we have to evangelize, you know. People have to hear the good news. They have to hear the word of God. And others are not changing as a result of not hearing the word of God. But if we reach out to them in love and, you know, being concerned about their well-being, we reach out to them and preach them. And by the end of the day, they will change. Why? Because there is somebody who has, you know, made that sacrifice to go out there to preach to somebody out of love. And together, we shall glorify the name of the Most High God. So we're still talking about partnership and still encouraging our viewers out there, you know, to partner with Revelation TV and just getting to be a blessing to the work of God. Because by the end of the day, we have to see to agree to say the entire world, you know, gets saved, the entire world gets delivered out of sin, they get delivered out of poverty, stagnation, limitation, you know, whatever it is that, you know, we do experience in this world, whatsoever obstacles we do experience, that is why we still keep on, you know, emphasizing the fact that let us be soul winners, let us go out there, venture into the world, evangelize, preach the gospel, preach the good news. So winning is a commissioning. God is commissioning us to go out there, you know, into the entire world and, you know, make disciples of one nation. We have to make sure to say those ones that will preach to us well, they'll preach to others. Those that will preach to others also preach to the others. And we see to it to say, the kingdom of darkness is going to decrease. Why? Because we have chosen to cooperate, we have chosen to work together just to see it really say at the end of the day, somebody, you know, lives a righteous life. Somebody receives Jesus Christ into their lives, and heaven will rejoice over one soul that is won. So partner with us. We have to see it really say out there, souls are won for Jesus Christ. As I was saying, you can partner with us with a 200 kwacha, a 300, a 500. As far as God can bless you, you can make that decision now by tapping into this grace, this anointing, this power. And I know that you'll be connecting yourself to the power that is upon Revelation TV. You'll be connecting yourself to the grace. Who knows what God can do for you? Who knows, maybe you might also just open a TV station as a result of, you know, sowing a seed into Revelation TV and just being concerned for somebody out there. So now, right just now, make that decision by partnering with us through Zapit. The number always runs on your screen. When we are giving, let us give out of love and from the bottom of our hearts, not to show off, not to, you know, to be seen by men that yes, we are the ones that gives the most. No ways. Let us give because we are giving to God, not giving to the apostle of God, but we are giving to the work of God, just to see to it, to say we go beyond this and we move together as a nation and as children of the Most High God.
Yeah, I think like you mentioned that the harvest is plenty, but the workers are few. And you know, when we get baptized and we get saved, we need to keep on moving forward and to make sure that we have more people coming. Because if you start backsliding, like the Bible said, it says that no one who puts his hand to the plow and looks back is fit for service in the kingdom of God. So if we get baptized or saved, and then we continue looking back instead of us focusing on winning more souls, okay, then we are not fit for the kingdom of God. And like just to attribute what you said, where Jesus sent out the 72 ahead of him, like the book here of Luke chapter 10. Verse 1 and 3 says that after this the Lord appointed 72 others and sent them 2 by 2 ahead to every town and place where he was about to go. He told them the harvest is plentiful, like you said, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest, therefore, to send out workers into his harvest field. Go, I'm sending you out like lambs among wolves. And verse 17 says, the 72 returned with joy and said, Lord, even the demons submit to us in your name. And Jesus replied to say, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. I've given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and overcome all the power of the enemy, and nothing will harm you. However, okay, do not rejoice that the spirit submit to you, but rejoice that your names are written in heaven. Okay, so like you mentioned that you have the harvest is there are plenty. Okay, people need the gospel out there are plenty, but the workers here we are few. Okay, like we mentioned to say that God, you know, calls us, but we do not respond. Okay, God wants us to go and harvest because there are plenty of harvest out there, but only a few people are listening to God's call to go and, you know, and evangelize and harvest millions of people that need to know Jesus, okay? And he said, once we do that, okay, then we'll be given authority, okay? Like in verse 18 and verse 19, I've given you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome all the power of the enemy, and nothing will harm you. So the moment we know we engage in soul winning, evangelizing, okay, preaching the gospel, God has given us the authority to trample on snakes, scorpions. Okay, all these are poisonous creatures, but they are not harmless. But he's saying that we should not rejoice that we have power over our enemies, but should be happy that our names are written in the book of written in heaven. So the moment we go out there to evangelize, okay, we win more souls, we trample, we win more souls, we get to know Jesus and repent. Okay? God gives us the power to trample on snakes and scorpions without them hating us. And he's saying that we should not rejoice okay, that we are able to trample on our enemies, but that our names are written what? In heaven. So that should be a driving factor of us to go out there and evangelize, to say, when we get more people to Jesus Christ, our names will be what? written up here in heaven,
mm-hmm.
and we need to rejoice. Okay, like we keep on saying that one person going, getting to know Jesus is, happiness and joy in heaven. So that should also motivate us to say, even one person that we get to Jesus Christ, okay, mm-hmm. we create more celebrations in heaven. Now, suppose you are between you and me, we get 10 people to know Jesus, then there will be more celebration. And so if you are also watching, be part of the celebration in heaven, okay, mm-hmm. by helping, the work of God to go forward. Like we mentioned when we opened to say that when you give, you're not giving to an apostle speaker, you're giving to God.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not doing God a favor by giving, but you're doing yourself a favor. Because it's like an insurance cover.
Mm-hmm.
When you give to this ministry, we'll reach out to more people. Like we mentioned that the TV station comes with a lot of running costs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and this is a non-profit making television station.
Mm-hmm.
And it being on air depends on the support that we have out there. And even us sitting here, all these things that you are seeing behind us, my cameras were using the microphones, were as a result of the partners that came on board to make sure that the vision that the apostle speak had, became a reality. And so you can keep on also supplementing so that we build on what our other partners have done here by helping us, set up this wonderful studio. We also have Studio 3, which is also needs to be completed. The building is done. Now it needs also equipment. Studio 1 also there, also the other things that we need to put on. Even here in Studio 2, we need to put on a phone line so that you and I are able to interact. Okay? You can't call in live here Studio 2 because we do not have a phone line to come from Studio 1 into here. So your partnership will help us also to put a phone system in Studio 2 so that we're able to interact with you. Okay? You call us. Maybe you want to find out more information about Vision TV, you want to partner, maybe you just want to send a word of encouragement like Elder Grover did.
Mm.
Okay, you're able to call in. So, partner with us, what you're also able to put in a phone in this studio.
Mm.
Studio 1, yes, they are able to call, but in the Studio 2, we need to put a phone system. Studio 3 also, they are out there, also needs equipment and also a phone system. So that, we have international standards.
Mm.
Of set of things in the studios, because Christians were not poor as such, because God is very rich and is able to bless us. But when He blesses us, also let's learn to give more to improve His work. So make sure that you get the number on the screen, you partner with us, so we're able to bring the phone system here. So that maybe even if you, by the end of this week, we're able to receive calls from you live right here in Studio 2. So that we're able to interact, and also we get to share ideas. But if we don't have a phone system in here, then we're not able to communicate or even interact with you. So if you're watching, just make any form of contribution, and become a partner and make sure that we have all the things that we need in this studio. And like I said, when you partner with us, we're also giving away this t-shirt for free for our partners. But even as we are moving, put on this t-shirt, you are feeling proud to say, I'm part of the great work of Adversion TV, and you'll be moving your head high to say, I've contributed towards someone who's watching out there and has gotten to know Jesus Christ through Adversion TV, and now they've found a church of their own nearby, in a nearby town where they stay, and they get baptized and saved. And it will make you proud to say, that person has known Jesus through my contribution. So the number is on the screen, you can simply get that number, like in the corner, and make your pledge and also your partnership so that you can continue to broadcast to millions of people who are watching out there. And if you're a man of God, a woman of God, it's just 250 kwacha, you come in the studio and also minister to people. And also, by you coming here and paying that 250 kwacha also, you are making the work of God also to move forward, because that money will also help us to meet certain needs that we need to sort out here at Vision TV. So you can get a number on the screen, you can book in advance, so that even tomorrow morning you're able to come. It's great that you are here, you also minister to people for 25 minutes at only 250 kwacha. And also through your ministry, someone will be touched, okay? and they'll get to know Jesus. So the man of God also, please just get the number on the screen. Make sure you call and then make a booking. Here's what we are going to come. Even tomorrow morning, you can come 2:50 kwacha for 25 minutes. And then you come and also minister. And just reach out to someone who's craving for that message that you have prepared. Because we have a church, we have a limited audience. Okay? Mm. We preach to a congregation. But someone also needs to get that message and preach to the church. Mm. Also, people want to hear it here on Innovation TV. So we can use this platform also to preach to millions of people the message that you preached yesterday on Sunday. And you can come and share it so that people also get blessed by your message.
Yes, indeed. I believe that viewers out there are getting blessed with this wonderful TV station that is all about delivering God's people, that is all about setting God's people free. It's not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. We're still emphasizing on the fact that partner with Revelation TV, tap into this grace, tap into this anointing. And I know as you just get to do that, God is going to come through for you and meet you at your very point of need. Connect yourself to this grace, connect yourself to this power. And as you make that decision to partner with us, you are guaranteed for a free t-shirt of My Story Must Change, as well as a free bottle of anointing oil, just in case you want anointing oil. We have all the five types of anointing oil available right here. Tabernacle Commission, Revival Center, the church, where every member is a pastor. So when you partner with us, in as much as yes, we're guaranteeing you for these lovely, beautiful t-shirts, we're also guaranteeing you for a free bottle of anointing oil. Just come through and we'll be able to give you a free t-shirt and a free bottle if you partner with us, supporting the work of God, remembering the work of God. We have to touch the entire world, the entire nations, and we should not stop, spreading the gospel. We should not stop ministering the gospel, because by the end of the day, heaven and death will pass away, but the word of God shall live forever. So what is it we have to stand upon today? What is it we have to stand, holding it close to us, putting it, tight into our lives? That is the word of God. So we have to keep on preaching. We have to keep on, ministering to people out there. We have to keep on, preaching the good news, just to see, to read, to say, at the end of the day, we begin to touch lives, we begin to touch nations out there. Let us be wise winners, and that is winning a soul for Jesus Christ. Even as the word of God is telling us to say, let us all man nothing except God a soul. So let us not just sit down when we hear the good news. Let us preach to somebody. People are craving for the gospel. They want to hear the word of God. Let us not be selfish with the word of God. Let us not sit on the power of God. Even as God has given his power and authority, to trample on those scorpions, to trample on those serpents, but we only trample on them if we rise up on our feet, understanding the authority and the power that God has given unto us. Sometimes we think to say, only men of God can do cast out demons, only men of God can pray for somebody who is sick and they get healed. But the Bible says God has given us power and authority. It does not specify that God has given pastors or has given apostles or has given evangelists or teachers or, prophets. God has given, the power and the authority to everybody that accepts Jesus Christ as the Lord and personal Savior. And how can we realize that power that God has given unto us is us standing up on our feet and telling ourselves and, looking at the word of God, meditating on it and understanding that God has given us the power and authority. And we can pray for somebody out there. We can preach to somebody out there, because we are all preachers and we have to preach to God's people, and just to see, to represent at the end of the day, somebody, yields to the power of God, somebody yields to the Spirit of God. We have to keep on conversing people out there, convincing them to say, hey, my brother, my sister, God loves you. God is calling you into his kingdom. He wants nothing but the best for you. So let us not stop, winning souls out there. We have to touch lives, touch nations. Revelation TV is everywhere. People are watching everywhere, not just in Zambia alone, but also outside Zambia, in Senegal, Sierra Leone, people are watching Revelation TV. And we have to see, if somebody in Senegal, gives their life to Jesus Christ, somebody in, Sierra Leone gives their life to Jesus Christ by you making that decision to partner with us, so that we buy a lot of things here that will help us, move from one dimension to the other dimension. Like Mr. Kaimbo was saying, all these facilities that we're seeing right here in the Revelation Studios are as a result of, our partners out there that have made that decision to support the work of God and to move with the man of God's vision. So if we want to buy a lot of things, we want to buy, you know, plenty of stuff that will help Revelation TV keep on running. Yes, we do love to watch it. We do love to see every program that runs on it. But by the end of the day, those programs are able to, you know, to run on Revelation TV as a result of our partners that are partnering with us. So we keep on emphasizing to say, partner with us, sow that seed into Revelation TV. And I know that seed that you are going to sow, it will keep on growing and growing and growing and growing and growing. At the end of the day, you're going to, you know, see the benefit of sowing that seed. You're going to, you know, reap the fruits out of you sowing that seed into Revelation TV. And I know that those fruits that you're going to reap are big fruits, because this is the work of God. This is a mandate. It's a revelation that, you know, the man of God has just to see you to say God's people are delivered. So let us not stop, you know, preaching the gospel. Let us not stop ministering to lost souls out there. If we look at the Bible biblically, looking at, you know, the lost sheep, the lost coin, you know, if, example, in the lost sheep, if, you know, there was this, the sheep keeper, the shepherd went to look for one sheep that, you know, just disappeared, and he left the, you know, the 99 sheep and just went to look for the one sheep. Imagine one sheep that just disappeared. That's what we should, you know, do as Christians. Let us not say no, be content with everything, saying as long as, you know, these are the people that come to church, these are the people that know God, it's fine. No, let us, you know, consider even one that is out there that needs to come to Jesus Christ, that needs to accept Jesus Christ, and run for those very people that are out there and bring them back, so that, you know, the number is made complete in Christ. And the coin, like look at the lost coin, that man would have said, okay, it's fine, I can use this amount that I'm remaining with these very coins, I can use it to buy other things. But, you know, he went ahead and looked after that coin, and he found that coin, and everything was made complete. So we have to complete the kingdom of God. Yes, there are, everyone has accepted Jesus Christ, others have accepted, but there are also others that have to make the kingdom of God complete, and together we shall glorify the name of the Lord God Almighty. So let us rise up on our feet and say, hey, I choose to be a soul winner for Jesus. I want to preach to somebody, in as much as I love the fact that I've accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior, and I know that I'm having eternal life. We have to see to it. Also, somebody out there, you know, should receive Jesus Christ and experience an eternal life. So partner with us. Make that decision now. You know, rise up on your feet and tell yourself, oh my God, I choose to walk with the man of God's vision, because this is not a small vision, it's a very big vision. It's not just a Christian channel in Zambia, but I believe it's everywhere internationally. God's people have to be touched. Sow that amount into Revelation TV. And these t-shirts of my Story Must Change with Apostle Stanford Twitter are a guarantee to you. A guarantee, I mean a guarantee, being given to you for free of charge at no cost at all. Let us rise up on our feet and see you to say the ball keeps on rolling. We have to, you know, win souls out there for Jesus Christ. And we know to say, in as much as we are called, we have to respond to the call of God by the end of the day. So just being called and sitting, which means we're sitting on our blessings. There are certain blessings that we do sit on as a result of us not rising up on our feet and evangelizing and preaching the gospel. We have to, you know, get those blessings as us preaching the good news out there, spreading the gospel, and we see that all the days of our lives we have a blessed life. Yeah.
And as you mentioned to say, you know, people who give, most of the times they are leaders, you know that.
Mm.
Okay? If you do not give, then you'll be, you know, where you are.
Yes.
No movement. Because God searches the heart before he blesses.
Mm.
So if God sees that if I bless this person, no one will benefit from my blessing.
Mm.
Okay, then you remain where you are, stagnant.
Mm.
And then you'll be complaining to yourself, how come me, all my friends, for example, you're in technology at school, Mazanga won't say they're doing better, but me, I'm just stuck.
Mm.
Then you have to do a self introspection to see what are you doing.
Mm.
Because most people who give, okay, are people who are rich, okay, the people who are leaders, okay, because you can't be a leader if you're not able to give. Because even in church, okay, tithers, okay, leaders, in fact, in church leaders, are the people who normally give the most, okay? Because, you know, if you're a leader, you give more, God blesses you also.
Mm.
If you give, God will make you rich. But if you are, you know, short-handed person, okay? Because God will set you how to say, if I give this one blessings, No one's going to benefit from my giving. But a cheerful giver always receives more.
Amen.
Because like we've been saying that a closed arm is a closed what? Destiny.
Mm.
Because if you hold on to your possessions and you keep them, nothing more will be handed on to. Because like I gave an example last time to say, if you're adding sugar in water, it's a level it reaches, okay, of saturation point where sugar stops to dissolve.
Yes.
Okay. So if you give more, okay, God will bless you abundantly to the level whereby, okay, you have surplus, overflowing both. Okay. And in, when God, if you give, okay, apart from you having, you know, more, because you also make a blessing to what? To other people. Okay. Because you can give to RTV today, okay? And God is going to search the heart of someone else to come and bless you. Because God cannot just pour down money to cause inflation. So God should give, okay? God is going to find someone else within the community or the country. Maybe someone might come as far as Zambezi, where I come from, okay? To travel to Osaka and to come and bless you to say, no, God touched me and said I should give you this. Okay? And you'll be surprised. But I don't know you at all. Just have. Maybe you saw 1,000. Someone just come and say, no, sister, I've come coming from Zambezi. God just told me to come to you and give you a check of 1 million kwacha the best. Okay? So God has searched your heart to say, if I give my daughter this amount of money, she's going to be a blessing to other people. Now, if you are a short-handed kind of person who cannot give, okay, when you have, then there's a problem because no amount of blessing will follow you because you are selfish, like we were discussing last week. You are selfish. All you think about is what is yourself, your personal interest. Other people's interest to you, they don't matter. So if you, other people's interest to you don't matter, then even God won't matter to you and He will keep you there, where you are, okay? To say, okay, you sit here and see if your selfishness what will move you forward. Because sometimes we remain stagnant. It's not because God does not care for us, but because He searches our heart and says, if I give this person, this man, or say, one, you make other people suffer, okay? You're going to trample on a lot of innocent people. Okay, want to expand that, but that took anyone, right? Because people, they say, people are humble when they are poor, but give them money, you see their true colors.
Yeah.
Okay? When someone is broke, when they drum, they will come, boss, very humble, but give them money, you see their true colors. Can you please put this chair properly? Who are you to tell me how to sit? Why are you to tell me how I should put this chair? Okay? So God will search you and say, if I give this person money, how many people are going to suffer? How many people is He going to bless? Okay? So if He blesses you in investments, it means now help and bless other people also. So that they also get to experience the love of God. Because your giving, okay, will make someone also to know, no, there's someone, there's God. Okay? God really exists. Because they have seen God in you. Okay, if you give, someone will hope, like we said last time, that God is what love, light, and what the word. So the moment you achieve, you give to the needy, okay, that person will see, they will see, but they want to know you more. So through trying to know who senior is, okay, then they get, this person is a Christian, you have a background, okay, and that person will be also encouraged to say, okay, let me know more about it. A faith, okay? They'll get to know more about your faith, and by doing that also they get saved. So, let's tend to be cheerful givers, okay? We're not blessed so that we are able to chew the money for men. We chew it ourselves, or hoarding it, keeping it in the house, okay? God blesses us what we share our health with our people, because we came with nothing on earth, and we go with nothing. So, if we invest in the things of the world now, when we die, those things will remain here. And people are going to eat and enjoy them. But if you invest in the things of God, even as we depart here on earth, our treasures are built up in heaven. Because the Bible says that where your heart is, that's where your treasures If your treasures are, if your heart is in the world, then you build your treasures in worldly things. But if your heart is on godly things, then your treasures are built where? In heaven. Because there no one will go, no fearful will break into and steal what your treasure. Or no amount of cockroaches or rats will go there and eat part of your treasure. No, because there it is secured. Okay?
Mm.
The way it is, you find it very intact. Okay? Because God has the keys to your treasure. When you go there, He'll give you this special keys in you. That is your treasure, you're going to open it. Okay? Mm. But if we, you know, put you do much on investing on everything, okay? It is good to invest for future.
Yes.
Okay? That's a fact. We invest for the future of our children and our relatives. Yes, we invest, we keep money aside for unforeseen circumstances. But again, we need to also invest where? In heaven.
Mm.
Because yes, we have invested for unforeseen things here on earth.
Mm.
But what happens when we go? Because God will just come and say, today I'm cutting short your life.
Mm.
What are you going to do?
Mm.
Okay? There's no negotiations, no. Say, I'm going to cut off today, I'm not going to leave. Then you have nothing. Okay? It's like you retire and you suffer and you say, I'm going to the village. And yet you have nowhere to go and start your life from. You have no piece of land there, you have no relatives.
Mm-hmm.
You just move from Lusaka and go to Petaoke, with Petaoke or Ndazi, the village.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's no one to know that side. Okay? You'll be stranded there. Okay? Mm-hmm. Same thing applies when we live here. Okay? You need to have somewhere to start your life from.
Mm-hmm.
So you build treasures in heaven, but when you are no more here in heaven, you have somewhere to go and start from.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So let's just be encouraged to partner. The numbers on the screen, but simply call and also make your pledge and also become a partner of Revelation TV.
Mm-hmm. Indeed, this is a moment of devotion that comes to you live every day from 7:30 hours to 9:30 hours. And I'm hoping that your viewers are being encouraged by what we have for you this morning, encouraging you on the importance of giving, not only giving, but also giving out of a cheerful heart. And God loves a cheerful giver. So if you want to tap into those heavenly blessings that God has actually, you know, prepared for us, we should learn to be cheerful givers. Let us give out of love, out of concern for others, not out of for the sake of giving, because, you know, they're lacking and they want to provide, you know. We should always give out of a cheerful heart, and together we shall glorify the name of the Lord God Almighty. So you are a woman of God out there, a man of God out there. You can come through to Revelation TV and just be a blessing to God's people out there by ministering right here on Moment of Devotion at only a cost of 250 kwacha. 550 kwachas. I know that somebody out there will be blessed, a soul out there will be born for Jesus. Even as we are, you know, in the business of winning souls out there, we're in the business of, you know, investing in the things of God. And I know that God is going to come to for us, and together we shall glorify the name of the Lord God Almighty. So our viewers out there, do not forget Revelation TV. Even as, yes, as Mr. Gumbo was saying, you're investing in these other things, these worldly things, you know, remember to also invest in the things of God, because by the end of day, it's not by might nor by power, but by the Spirit of the living God. We have to touch nations, we have to touch the world, we have to go beyond this as RTV. We have to deliver God's people. And how can we do that? We can only do that as a result of you, our viewers, partnering with us and being a blessing to the work of God. Remember to say that these teachers are actually guaranteed to every partner of My Story Must Change. Even as, you know, in front of it is written, My Story Must Change, and behind the written, My Father, My Father. So you can start by shouting from behind, telling yourself, My Father, My Father, My Story Must Change. And I know that God is going to meet your financial needs as you also make that decision, you know, to sow a seed into Revelation TV, the channel that is all about delivering God's word. Together we shall glorify the name of God. So women of God, we're still inviting you out there, men of God, we're still inviting you to come through to Revelation TV and minister on Moments of Devotion at 250 kwacha only for 25 minutes. And we know that God is going to see you through, and you'll be preaching to people out there. God is also going to remember you as a result of you want to live a selfless life, not just being, you know, having interest above the interest of others, but being, you know, interested in someone's well-being. And together we shall glorify the name of the Most High God. So don't forget that Moment of Devotion comes to you live every day, starting Mondays to Fridays, just to see, to read, to say, you know, souls are won out there. You know, we draw, you know, God's people closer to God each and every day and on a daily basis. And together, we shall move together as one. United we stand, divided we fall. Let us rather choose to be united, because we know when we are united, even as the Word of God tells us to say that, you know, where there is unity, God commands a blessing. So if you want to be blessed into our life, you should start by uniting together as a nation, uniting together as children of the Most High God. And you know, God is not an author of confusion, he's an author of peace. So we should all always live in peace, and God is just going to see us through. Well, Mr. Kayumbo, we are concluding and just saying goodbye just now. Well, obvious, thanks for watching Moment of Devotion from me and Mr. Lovely Kayumbo. It's bye-bye. Meet you again tomorrow at the same time. Same place. It's bye-bye. Yeah, yes. Yeah.